as analysts predict an escalation to the violence in Burundi, the country's Senate Speaker, Reverien Ndikuriyo, has shared a more optimistic vision for the country, dispelling the likelihood of more violence in East Africa's smallest country. Well, he spoke during a courtesy call to Kenya Senate Speaker Ekwee Ethuro. Tricks Ingado brings us the details.
The increasing spate of violent attacks and killings in Burundi has led to international fears of an all-out ethnic conflict. Burundi's Senate Speaker, Reverien Ndikuriyo, has dismissed any speculation about the possibility of increased violence in the country.
Polisi wanatekwa, wanachinjwa. Tukaona kwamba hiyo ni kitendo cha ugaidi. Na sisi Burundi tunajua kwamba tunapambana na ugaidi, tuko Somalia, tuko Afrika ya Kati. Meli ya Burundi inashughulikia. Serikali imeanzisha msako kwa nguvu. Na silaha nyingi zimeshakamatwa.
He was speaking during a courtesy visit to Kenyan Senate Speaker Ekwee Ethuro when he urged those propagating violence in a few districts to stop, terming recent killings by unknown assailants as acts of terror.
Nchi nzima ni tulivu, isipokuwa hizo kata ine za Bujini, Bujumbura, na pale tutakusanya nguvu zetu tuweke pale, ni pole pole, kwa sababu kama mtu nakwambia mimi na gurumeti au nitazirusha zote mpaka ziishi hamtazikamata. Lazima kwamba huyo lazima tumshughulikie polepole.
Kenyan Senate Speaker also made an appeal to the people of Burundi to set aside their differences and stand for peace.
Shida ambalo liko katika nchi ya Burundi ni shida la siasa, sio kabila. Kama vile tulikuwa tunajua pengine awali hapo, lakini tunajua sisi wote wa Afrika tunayo shida ya ukabila, na tungeomba ya kwamba mnaona sisi Kenya pia tulipigana baada ya kura, lakini baada ya miezi miwili tulikaa chini tukasema serikali ni yetu yote.
This comes just days after US President Barack Obama sent an appeal to the citizens of the country to rise above the temptation to take up arms against one another because of political violence.
From Burundi's painful past, we know where this kind of violence can lead. Today, you have the chance to choose a different path. And you are not alone. For many years, your partners in the region and the United States have worked to help you build a peaceful and stronger country.
The US President asked the people of the Republic of Burundi to lend a deaf ear to political leaders spewing hateful rhetoric that might jeopardize the country's future.
To Burundi's leaders, now is the time to put aside the language of hate and division. Follow through on your commitment to participate in an internationally mediated dialogue outside of Burundi.
Kenyan President Uhuru Kenyatta also recently weighed in on the matter, asking the country's President Pierre Nkurunziza to save the country from violence. This comes as analysts warn of further escalation following a wave of killings. The warning from the Institute of Security Studies came as it emerged that another 7 people were killed and several others wounded in the latest violence in Burundi's capital over the weekend. The mayor of Bujumbura was also attacked a week after the launch of a crackdown search for weapons. Chixingado, KTN News.